Dr. Ari is called the Gandhi of Sri Lanka. To me, he's my grandfather, Sia. We want children in Sri Lanka to know him too. We want children around the world to know him as well.
Real education is awakening your human personality. It is silly to think that my family, my property, no. We are a part of the universe. I wanted to teach this to children.
Since this first Ramadana in 1958, Sarvodaya has organized over 100,000 Ramadanas, built many thousands of roads, 7,000 bridges, 5,000 preschools, and organized 100,000 water programs, benefiting 7 million people in 15,000 villages in 26 districts. It's simple. We build the road, and the road builds us.
So I had a good set of young students I could guide. They could understand this. So I said, now, if we are to really to learn, we should go in search of the poorest families in this country. I persuaded the parents of these students to allow them to come with me, go and live in this village, give some opportunity for the poor to get organized and enter the main society. And 2 weeks we were there, making a road from the main road to this village, digging wells, putting up houses, putting up industrial center like that. We were doing so many things. That is how the first camp. I learned from so many. To begin with, Mahatma Gandhi's pupil, Acharya Vinoba Bhave. So I learned my first lessons in community service with him in India. Then of course I had met most of the national leaders of India. Then, like a living Buddha, we have Dalai Lama. And I loved him very much, respected him very much. He loved me too. Another great personality I met was Dr. Deepak Chopra. He invited me to his center in the United States. And here in this, we have the President of India, Abdul Kalam. He visited this house and our center. So, and Mrs. Clinton was the one who invited us to visit the White House. She was a very nice lady.
For Sarvodaya's 60th anniversary, it was great to have the opportunity to meet with so many of these world leaders who travelled all the way to Sri Lanka just to celebrate it with us.
In 1961, we collected 1,000 people. We hired a train and went to Jaffna. We were welcomed by about 4,000 people. We did the Ramadan and walk, maybe 7-8 miles. That was the first peace march. 1983, there was big riots in this country. With groups of Sarvodaya people, I went everywhere. Don't be afraid. We can solve all our problems non-violent. Peace conferences, peace walks, 100,000 nearly. People assembled for a peace meditation. It was not easy. We had love for everybody through non-violence. So many peace marches we did. And Anuradhapura was the biggest one, where nearly 1 million people participated.
During the 30 years, Sarvodaya joined hands together with communities and organized over 100,000 peace marches. Today, the war is over. Our country has been at peace since 2009. We are so blessed to live in peace once again.
Sarvodaya, they organized a Shumadana camp back in 2018. And one thing I realized was that they didn't have a proper knowledge of English. They had phones, washing machines, to everything, but they didn't have the simple knowledge of English. That's when I came up with the idea with my cousins and friends to start off Youth Force.
English being an international language is the key to being a part of the modern world.
We may be thorough with our English, but there are so many children out there who have no basic knowledge of their ABCs. We must be considerate. Those books were only written for us.
Yes, so what we do is we go and teach children English, and we also make libraries for them so that they can like make their knowledge of English even better.
The Youth First project is at the foot of our largest rainforest. It's so beautiful there, with colorful birds, flowers, animals, and big trees. It's the most biodiverse in all of Sri Lanka. We will collect seeds from these big trees to plant in Colombo to protect us from climate change, landslides, and beach erosion.
Very good, very good. That is how ICE 2 started now.
Sia, tell us a bit about the cooperative movement that you started when you were 14 years old.
When I come to the main road from home on my push bicycle, there was a lady asked me for 25 cents. So every week I used to give her 25 cents. So one day, when I was going on the coast, I saw her making koyaan. So I went to her and asked, why you ask me for money every Monday? What are you doing with this money, you earn? He said, I earn 2 rupees a week. So from 2 rupees this woman gets, those people get 20 rupees profit. So I started, while teaching, I started the cooperative society for those women who are doing choir. That's how I started.
Dr. Ari's message is always the same. By awakening one person, it awakens a whole family, then an entire community, and then one day, even the world. We want all young people to awaken to their potential. We promise to help carry on our grandfather's legacy. We hope you will join us.